Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
An investment company involved in Islamic banking called I Monitor Advisory, run by a man called Mohammed Mansur Khan, is under probe by the police for cheating more than 25,000 people to the tune of 1,500 crores. And the police now believe that this could also touch close to 5,000 crores. Now, Mansur Khan, who's a Gulf turned businessman, has been running IME, as this company has been called, from 2006. And the offices of IME, which is spread right across Bangalore, has now seen people from various fields who are coming and standing in line because these investors say that Mansur Khan has cheated them of their money and they're demanding their money back. Tell me, what was your investment for? My
daughter's marriage.
Now, the IME group has been dealing with the gold and diamond sector for nearly 13 years, and slowly as the business picked up, they expanded into bullion trading, infrastructure, printing, publishing, healthcare, and also perfumeries. Now, if you look at the way Khan tapped this unorganized Islamic banking sector, the scheme which he actually gave to people is very simple. Now, according to Islamic law, levying interest rates, just as banks do, is known as anti-Islamic or haram. So, IME claimed that they would invest in gold and silver bars, and later the profits that are taken from this kind of businesses is then given to the investors. Now, this is what is called largely Islamic banking, and people who have invested in this are called sleeping partners. If you look at the way he has convinced people, now he has provided in schemes for marriage of the girl child, education of children, scholarship abroad, and even investments for further businesses. And he has also promised people that they would get close to 7% profit on a monthly basis. So on a yearly basis, people would get close to 35 to 38% profit on the money that they have invested. The whole process is very simple. One needs to invest 50,000 rupees or multiple of 50,000 rupees. And once that this is done, then Mansur Khan would invest this money in gold and silver bars, to which he would get close to almost 100% profit. From that, he would give around 7 to 10% profit on a monthly basis to his investors. People were convinced because he was doing this for 13 years. He had also got hefty returns. But since January this year, people have not received money. And it is on June 9th when they realized that no money has come into their account that people started complaining. The first complaint to the police was on June 9th. But since then, the police have now found out that Mansur Khan and his family would have fled the country to Dubai.
The developments that have taken place, the arrests that you have done, are these people directly involved with the IMA scam?
Directly involved with the IMA scam, and these people are directors in different entities that belong to IMA. There are close to almost like 15 entities that we could make out till now. So they have got, they're directors in this company. They've got share, the ownership of them is from 0.02 to 0.003. Very small partnership that they've got. But they are essentially all people who are working on the field for the company, probably. Since they worked hard, they have been made directors, or maybe to form companies, they have been made directors.
Now the investigation is on. The government has set up a special investigative team dedicatedly to probe into this particular case. But at the same time, we're also looking at a bigger problem, that this Islamic banking and the frauds associated with it is causing a lot of trouble and a lot of cheating cases, especially of people who blindly believe in such kind of fraudsters. So in the end, now the police also believe that after the investigations, they will also bring a crackdown on several such schemes that are being provided and ensure that people do not fall prey to such kind of scams and fraudsters. And furthermore, the government of Karnataka also is now contemplating whether they should bring about a specific law curbing such kind of cases, and also try and bring such kind of banking and finance schemes under the SEBI and the RBI. Roni Swami in Bengaluru, ThePrint.